kita nak tengok on interval estimation for the difference between two population means. Okay, so previous class, we already looked at one population mean. Okay, so for this one. Now, kita nak tengok on two population mean. Okay, so before we continue to two population means, so kita tengok dulu on the tutorial for one population mean. Okay. So, for tutorial 3, for one population mean for questions December 2019. So, in these questions, okay, so bila questions ni dah kata for a sample of 15 apartment, so we know that this case is for variance or standard deviation for the population is unknown, okay? And this is the value your sample size for sample and mean for sample. Standard deviation for sample and standard error mean. Okay, so this should be S lah, not sigma. Okay, and then we know that if the case is variance or standard deviation for the population is unknown, okay, we should check the value for N. Either N is more than or equal to 30 or N is less than 30. Since in this case, our N is less than 30, so to solve this problem, we should use T distribution. Okay. So for A, name the statistical method used in the study. Give a reason to support your answer. So in this case, we will use T distribution. Okay. Ataupun one sample T test. Okay. So so itulah dia punya jawapan dia. Okay. One sample T test. So the reason is because there is only 15 sample being used. Or lebih tepat lagi kita kata because the sample size less than 30 lah. Okay. Is less than 30. Okay. So this is the answer for A. Okay, statistical method. So for B, construct 90% confidence interval for the true mean monthly rented for a two-bedroom apartment in XYZ town. So this will construct 95% confidence interval. So we know that we will use this formula. Okay, since the case is N is less than 30. So you are going to T distribution. So just substitute the value. Okay, so ini you tertinggal you punya degree of freedom. So kena ada kat sini. Okay, 14. Alright, so this is your X bar. So your X bar is this one, this value. And then for standard error mean ni, you just substitute this value since we know that this is the value for S over square of N. Okay, so just substitute the value. And then you will get this value, okay? 874.5313 and your upper limit is 985.7353, okay? So make sure you show this value, okay, from the statistical table 1.76. And then for this one ni, you tak perlu tunjuk pun tak apa, okay? So kalau nak tunjuk pun tak ada masalah lah. Okay? Tapi tak perlu nak, apa nama itu, waste your time. Okay, just yang ini and then you terus. Ataupun yang ini pun tak perlu pun. Okay, just use calculator and then masukkan je 930.133 minus 1.76 times with this one. So you dapat your lower value and then change from minus to plus and then you dapat your upper limit. Okay, so this two row ni tak perlu pun tak apa. Okay, so you just buat this one and this one. Okay, so this is for questions B. And then for C, based on the value in B is the mean monthly rented for a two-bedroom apartment in XYZ town different from 984. So in this case, since the question asks you either the mean is different from 950, so kita kena tengok the value for 950 ni either dia punya value tu ada dalam confidence interval or not in the confidence interval. Okay, so this is our confidence interval. Okay, so we have 874.53 to 985.74. So 950 is between or in the confidence interval. So this is the value. So since the value of 950 is in the confidence interval, so the mean monthly rented to should be equal lah. Okay, but in the questions, dia tanya is the mean monthly rented is different from 950. So kita cakap no, okay. We cannot conclude that the mean length of monthly rented for a two bedroom apartment is different. So yang ni you follow je, you follow je ayat dia, tak perlu nak tukar. We cannot conclude that the mean length of monthly rented for a two bedroom apartment in XYZ is different from RM950 since RM950 is in. So yang ni you tak perlu cakap dalam, tak perlu buat macam ni pun, you just cakap je since RM950 is in the confidence interval. Okay, so macam tu je. Okay, so kita kata no, we cannot conclude that the mean monthly rented for a two bedroom apartment in XYZ town is different from RM950 since RM950 is in the confidence interval. Okay, so macam tu je. Okay, so this is for questions C for December 2019. So next we look at on the questions June 2019. Okay, so in this case the statistic lecturer intend to investigate whether there is sufficient evidence to conclude the average score was different from the expected average of score 74. So this is your average for population, your mu. Okay, so a random sample of 15 students. So you know that this is the case for variance or standard deviation for the population is unknown since the data only take a sample of 15 students. And then the result, so the result for the 15 student is this one. So this is your N, your X bar, your S and S over square of N. So we know that this is the case for variance or standard deviation for the population is unknown. So bila unknown, we will check our N. So since N is less than the T, so we will use T distribution. Okay. So for A, identify the statistical test used for this study. Okay, so kita akan guna one sample T test. Okay, so they only ask you the statistical method, so only this one je lah. Okay, so yang ni tak perlu pun tak apa. Okay, alright, so that is for A. And then for B, show the standard error of the mean is 3.5002. So dia suruh show sahaja. Okay, so the formula, we know that the formula is S over square of N. So just substitute je lah dekat dalam equation. So this is your standard deviation and this is your square of N. Okay, so ini bahagi dengan square of N. So you will get this answer. Since the question asks you to show in four decimal places, so you just follow the value. So that is for B. And then for C, construct a 95% confidence interval for the average score. So we know that we will use T distribution. So just substitute the value for X bar is this one, and then 95%, so alpha over 2 is 0.025, and this is our degree of freedom, 15 minus 1, so 14, and this is the value our standard error mean, this one lah. Okay, so just substitute the value. So nanti you akan dapat the value is 66.9791 and your upper limit is 81.9950. Okay, so this will be your answer. Okay, for C. So for D, okay, based on the confidence interval in C, does the average score differ from 74? Give a reason to support your answer. So dia tanya either the average score differ from 74. So kita kena check from the interval ni either 74 is in the confidence interval or not. So kalau kita tengok 74 is in the confidence interval, so kita akan kata dia equal lah. Okay, but the question ask you either the average is differ. So kita tak boleh nak kata dia differ. Okay, so kalau differ, 74 ni mesti not in the confidence interval. Okay, so kat sini kita akan kata no. Okay, we cannot conclude that the mean average score is differ from 74 since 74 is in the confidence interval. Okay, so itu adalah cara how to answer for questions D. Okay, so since this one ada dalam confidence interval, so kita kata the average score is equal. But the question asks you either the average score is differ, so kita kata no. We cannot conclude that the mean average score differ from 74 since 74 is in the confidence interval. Okay, so this is for questions June 2019. So we go to the next questions, December 2018. Okay, so for these questions, okay, dia bagi kat situ the analysis of previous 20 monthly bills given the following result. Okay, so this is the data for only 20 months bill. Okay, and then yang ni dia kata the manager claim that the average monthly electricity bill is RM700. So this is your mean for the population. So macam biasa, so we know that this is one sample statistic. So we know that statistic is the measurement for sample. So this is your N, your X bar, your S over square of N. Okay, so for A, show that K is 25.6585. Okay, so this suruh show this value. So macam biasa saja. Okay, only substitute the value into the equations. Okay, so kita tahu, okay, so kita tahu the value is, so K ni sama dengan value of SE, which is sama dengan this value. Okay, sekejap, kawan ni buat. So kita kata K ni sama dengan SE and then sama dengan S over square of N. So we know that the value for kita nak find the value of K, so kita just buat 114.5695 over square root of 20. So this one lah. So nanti akan dapat this value 25.6185. Okay, so dia suruh show in 4 decimal places. So this one lah. Okay, so itu answer for A. Therefore B, calculate the 90% confidence interval. So sama, since the case is variant or standard deviation for the population is unknown. So nak tahu either we use Z or T. So we look at the number of sample. So since the number of sample is less than 30, so we will use T distribution. Okay, so kita guna T distribution. So kat sini nanti akan dapat this value. Okay. And then bila you baca table, so you akan dapat 1.729. And then this one you tak perlu buat. Okay, terus je 661.5056 and 750.0944. Okay, so you need, no need to show. Okay, tak perlu pun. And then that is for B, for 90%. And then for 95%, okay, so just change the value for alpha over 2. So nanti kat sini jadi 0.025 and then the value from the table should be 2.093. And then this one tak perlu show. And nanti you akan dapat your lower limit is 652.1805 and your upper limit 759.4195. Okay, so this should be your answer, your final answer. And then dia suruh you based on the confidence interval, is the manager claim true? So the manager claim that the average is 700, maksudnya equal to 700. So to say that the claim is true, 700 tu must be in the confidence interval. So dia kata based on the confidence interval in B, so we should look at this confidence interval. Okay, so kita tengok yang from 661.5056 and 750.0944. So dia punya claim is 700. So kalau kita tengok 700 is in the confidence interval, so kita kata is equal. Okay, and then the manager memang claim the average monthly electricity is RM700. So kita akan kata yes. Okay, we can conclude that the average monthly electricity bill is RM700. Okay, ataupun yes, we can conclude that the manager's claim is true. Okay, since RM700 is in the confidence interval. Okay, so macam tu je lah. Maksudnya kita kata yes, we can conclude that the manager claim is true. Okay, since RM700 is in the confidence interval. Okay, since the manager claimed that the monthly, the average monthly electricity bill is RM700. Okay, so that is for D. And the last one for E, what can be concluded based on the confidence interval? So bila kita tengok, kita compare for both confidence interval, 90 and 95% confidence interval. So kita akan kata, this one je lah, you can conclude this one. Okay, the higher the confidence level, the wider the confidence interval. Okay, so that is for questions E. Okay. And then yang ini your friends supposedly dia kena buat June 2018 tapi dia terbuat December 2018.
Oh, Miss, saya tersalah buat.
tak apa.
Sorry,
okay. Okay. So nanti sama je lah yang ni. Okay. Alright. So for June 2018, the question asks you to find the value of X. Okay, your standard deviation. So we know that we can get the value for standard deviation from this formula for standard error mean, which is the formula is S over square of N. So this value already given in the output, in the data. So we need to find the value of S. So just substitute the value. Okay, so now kita nak find S. So kita just times je lah. Okay, 0.4914 times with square of 28. So you akan dapat this value. Since the question asks you to find the value, so this should be the value lah, 2.6002. Okay, and then for B, construct 90% confidence interval. So since the case is variance or standard deviation for the population is unknown, and our N is less than 30, so we will use T distribution. Just substitute the value, okay? And then nanti you akan dapat your value for T distribution is 1.703 and your lower limit is this value and upper limit is this value. Okay, so this should be your confidence interval for question B. And then the last one, based on the confidence interval in B, is the mean travel distance from home to work by the employee ABC company different from 15 kilometer. So we know that to say that the average travel distance is different, 15 should be not in the confidence interval. Okay, so kalau kita tengok our confidence interval ni, okay. So kalau kita tengok 15 ni ada dalam confidence interval. So that's mean kita tak boleh nak kata dia differ from 15 kilometer. So kita kata no. Okay, the mean travel distance from home to work by the employees of ABC is not different from 15 kilometer. Why? Since 15 kilometer is in the confidence interval. Okay, so kalau kita punya interval ni, contohnya kita dapat from 13 to 14. So 15 is not in the confidence interval. So then yes lah. Yes, the mean is different from 15 kilometer since 15 kilometer is not in the confidence interval. Okay, so apa-apa we will refer to our confidence interval, our lower and upper limit. Okay, so that is for questions June 2018. Okay, so now we look at on the January 2018. So for January, dia bagi kat sini different and then conducted to investigate and then 50 store was selected. So in this question, so we know that this is the case for variance or standard deviation for the population is unknown since it given you the value for sample. And then dekat sini we know that the N is more than 30, okay, more than or equal to 30. And then this is our mean, standard deviation, standard error mean. So since the case is more than and equal to 30, so we will use this formula lah, Z distribution. Okay, so for A, show the standard error mean is 0.1181. So dia suruh show this value saja, just substitute. Okay, so just substitute the value. So nanti you dapat this value lah. Just show the value. And then construct a 99% confidence interval. So the value should be 0.005 and we should use Z distribution instead of Z. So kalau you guna T, memang wrong lah. Your answer will be wrong. You must use Z distribution. Okay, so just substitute the value and then when you read from the statistical table, so this should be the value. And then your lower limit will be 16.9698 and upper limit will be 17.5782. Okay, so this is your lower and upper limit. And then for C, the question asks you, based on the confidence interval in B, does the average price per kg of ikan kembung in market differ from RM17? So, macam biasa, so kita nak tengok differ ke tak, kita tengok 17 tu ada dekat mana dalam confidence interval kita. Okay, so since 17 is in the confidence interval, so kita akan kata dia equal. Okay, but the question asks you either the value is differ from RM17. So kita kata no. Okay, no, we cannot conclude that the average price per kg of ikan kembung is differ from RM16 since RM17 is in the confidence interval. Okay, so this is one mark, this is another one mark. Okay, so two marks kat situ. So that is for January 2018 and the last questions for July 2017. So this is the summary statistic for 14 customer. So macam biasa, this is your N, your X bar, S, S over square of N. So A macam biasa, show the standard error mean. So just show the value. Okay, just substitute the value and then you akan dapat this answer. Okay. And then since dia suruh show in 5 decimal places, so kat sini should be 5 lah. Okay. And then for B, construct a 95% confidence interval. So since less is n is less than 30, so we will use the distribution. So just substitute the value. So nanti you akan dapat.
Aku dah makan, tak kisah apa nak stay ke nak pergi ke.
Ha?
Okay.
Kimi.
Ah,
oh sorry, I'm sorry.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, so this one T0.0251. So when you read from statistical table, so the value should be 2.16. Okay, and then this is your lower and upper limit. Okay, so you akan dapat this value. So that is for B. And the last questions, based on the confidence interval in B, is the mean amount of money spent by the customer is different from 117. Okay, so kalau kita tengok the confidence interval, okay, sini 114.117. So 117 is here. Okay, so dia tak ada dalam your confidence interval. So kita akan kata dia unequal ataupun kita akan kata dia differ. Okay, ataupun ada increase or ada decrease. So the question memang ask you either the mean amount to different from 117. So kita akan kata yes. Okay, we can conclude that the mean amount of money by spent by the customer is differ from RM70 since RM70 is not in the confidence interval. Okay, so this is the answer for tutorial for one population mean. So any questions before we proceed to two population mean, boleh? Okay, boleh. So kalau boleh, kita nak tengok on two population mean. Okay, the difference between two population mean. Okay, so before this kita dah tengok on one population mean yang mana the case ada equal, the variance or standard deviation for the population is known or unknown. So bila known kita akan guna Z, bila unknown kita akan tengok the sample size either N more than or equal to 30 or N less than 30. So if the case is large sample, so we will use Z distribution, and if the case is small sample, so we will use T distribution. Okay, but for two population mean, okay, so for two population mean, the case will be divided into two, okay, either the case is independent sample or dependent sample. Okay, so for independent sample, same like the one population mean. So kita akan ada case either the variance or standard deviation for the population is known or unknown. Okay, so bila known, automatically we will use Z distribution. Okay, so for known, if the variance or standard deviation for the population is known, tak kisah your sample size either large or small, so you akan use this formula. But the case for variance or standard deviation for the population is unknown, we know that we have two population. Okay, so how to know either we will use Z distribution or N distribution, T distribution. So kita ada dua, kita ada N1 and N2. Okay, so if both samples, if both population, the value is N is more than 30. Okay, so then the case will be this one. Okay, N is more than or equal to 30 and we will use Z distribution. Okay, but if the value for sample size, for example, for N1 is more than 30, but for N2 is N is less than 30. So one more than 30 or more than equal to 30, and then another one is less than 30. So this one we conclude the case is N is less than 30. Okay, if one or both is small sample, so kita akan guna this one. Okay, this formula. Ataupun N1 kita ni memang N less than 30, and then N2 pun less than 30. So kita kata N less than 30. Okay, so we only use Z distribution is if both population tu memang sample size tu N more than and equal to 30. Okay, so if salah satu tu more than 30, so the case will not be this one lah. Okay, kita kena tengok pula. Apa nama itu? The case will be small sample, and then kita kena tengok pula either the variance or standard deviation for the population tu equal ke unequal. Okay, so if equal, we will use this formula yang ada SP ni. Okay, if the variance or standard deviation for the population is unequal, so kita akan guna formula yang tak ada SP. Okay, so kalau kita tengok on previous for one population mean. Okay, so we know that the degree of freedom is N minus 1. So this should be the degree of freedom for one population mean. But for two population mean, okay, the degree of freedom is different. Okay, so if the case is variance equal variance or equal standard deviation, so this should be the formula to calculate the degree of freedom for this case, equal variance. But if the case is unequal variance or unequal standard deviation, so this is the formula to calculate the value of your degree of freedom. Okay, so berbezalah dia punya formula dia. Okay, so that is basically on two population, difference between two population means. And the last one kita ada dependent lah. Okay, dependent sample. Okay, so this should be the formula for each case. And then this is how to calculate your mean difference, margin of error, and standard error difference. So before this, for one population mean, kita ada standard error mean. Okay, so this is we call as standard error mean for one population. But for two population, okay, kita akan panggil dia as standard error difference. Okay, tapi still the value ni memang yang after statistical table. So this is your standard error difference. So if the question asks you to find the standard error difference, so you know lah, this is the formula that you need to calculate. Okay, so this one will be the formula. Okay, so if the question asks you to find the margin of error, so margin of error ni the value after plus minus. Okay, your statistical table with your standard error difference. So this is your value for margin of error. And then your point estimate or your mean difference is this one. Okay, so if the question asks you to find the mean difference or the point estimate for two population mean, so this should be the formula lah. Okay, so this is just the summary from the formula. So from this formula, you can find the mean difference or point estimate, and then you can find the margin of error, and then you can find standard error difference. Okay, so that is the summary for this table. And then we go to the difference between independent and dependent sample. So what is the difference between these two? Okay, so for independent sample, okay, dia adalah the two sample are independent if they are draw from two different population and the element of first sample have no relationship for the element of the second sample. For example, to determine the difference in mean pH of rainfall in Shah Alam and Kelang. So Shah Alam and Kelang tu dia tak ada relationship pun, tak ada kaitan pun. Okay, dia tak ada effect pun the mean pH in Shah Alam, dia tak akan affect pun the mean pH in Kelang since dia dua tempat yang berbeza. Okay, two difference is, so two different population lah. Okay, but for dependent sample, two sample are dependent if they are draw from two different population and the element of first sample have relationship to the element of the second sample. So untuk dependent, dia berkait. Okay, so sometimes we call as match pair sample. Okay, so dia berkait lah the first and the second one tu. Okay, for example, to determine the effectiveness of Kevin Zahari diet program, so participant weight before and after program is measured. Okay, so for example, you have five participants. You have 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So the weight before and after the same participant will be measured. For example, we took the weight for first participant before he or she joined the program, diet program. For example, the weight is 65. All right, and then after he or she joined the program, so we will take the weight of the first participant. Masih lagi orang yang sama. Okay, so for example 60. Okay, sebab tu dekat sini dia kata dependent is apa nama itu, the two population tu have a relationship. Maksudnya dia berkait. Kita tak boleh take the value for participant tu. Dia dah jadi lain lah. Okay, mesti kita kena ambil pair. Mesti the first participant the weight before first participant, and then after pun mesti the same person. Okay, tak boleh kita ambil before first participant and then after tu kita ambil berat third participant. Contohnya macam tu. Dia mesti orang yang sama sebab dia mesti pair. Okay, mesti benda tu benda yang samalah. Okay, so that is for dependent. So dia punya difference dia, kalau independent ni dia, the two population tu have no relationship, but for dependent sample the two population tu dia ada relationship. So usually the questions dia akan bagi sama ada before after or with without. Okay, so maksudnya dia yang berkait. Okay, so itu example for dependent sample. And then dekat sini dia kata let mu1 and mu2 be the mean of the first and second population respectively. So we want to find the confidence interval of the difference between two population mean. Then x bar 1 minus x bar 2 is the sample statistic used to make the confidence interval. So before this, for one population mean, okay, to find the value, we only use x bar. Okay, so this is one population. But in this case, since we have two populations, so dia akan nak tengok difference between these two lah. Okay, so this is for two population. So beza dia dekat sini je lah. Okay, so one population, we only have one sample mean, but for two population, kita akan ada two sample mean. Yang mana kita nak cari the difference between these two. Okay, these two population. So we look at on the first case for independent, which is the case is variance or standard deviation for the population is known. So if the case is variance or standard deviation for the population is known, we know the value for population. Okay, so kita tahu berapa nilai dia. Okay, kita tahu nilai dia berapa. So kita dah tak perlu tengok on the sample size. Either the sample size is small or large, so we will use this formula. We will use Z distribution, and this should be sigma 1 square over N1 plus sigma 2 square over N2, since this is the value for standard deviation or variance for the population. Okay, so we look at on the first example, example 3.9. Okay, so in this example, an experiment was conducted in which two type of engine. We have engine A and B. So we know that this is the case for two population, since we have two population, which is A and B. And then gas mileage in miles per gallon was measured. So 75 experiments were conducted using engine type A and 50 experiments were done for engine type B. So we have two population. So we have A and B. Okay. So sama, you list kind all the information, okay? So in this case, we have a sample size of 75 for engine type A. So we have N A is equal to 75. And then we have 50 experiments were done for engine type B. So this is sample size for B. And then the gasoline use and other condition were held constants. So the average gas mileage per engine A was 42 miles per gallon. So we know that this average is for the sample lah, 75. So average for sample, okay, we denoted it as X bar. And the average for engine B was 36 miles per gallon. So this is for B. And then find 96% confidence interval on the difference between population A and B, mean population for A and B, where this mean population is for A and B respectively. So assume that the population standard deviation are 8 and 6. So the question given you the value for population standard deviation. So maksudnya this is the value for A and B. And we need to find the value for 0.04, so alpha over 2 is 0.02. Okay, So in this question, macam biasa, okay, we check either the standard deviation is for variance, sorry, is for the population or sample. Okay, so since in this case, the value of standard deviation is for the population, so we know that the case is variance or standard deviation for the population is known. So automatically, if known, kita terus guna this formula. Okay, dah tak perlu tengok on the sample size. Okay, so we will use this formula. So mu A minus mu B, since the question asks you to find the difference between A and B. So this one, just substitute the value. Okay, so just masukkan saja X bar A is 42 minus 36 and then plus minus Z 0.02 and then sigma A is 8 square over 75 plus 6 square over 50. Okay, so 42 minus 36, what will be the value?
Six.
Okay, so this is 6 and then Z 0.02, what is the value for Z 0.02?
Two point zero five three seven.
Okay, so that should be the value for this one. And then this one, nak selamat, you kira dulu. Okay, so nak selamat, you kira dulu square root of 8 square over 75 plus 6 square over 50. Okay, so you ambil in 4 decimal places. What will be the value for this one?
Satu point dua lima empat tiga.
Okay, and then lepas tu you buat apa? You dapatkan lower and upper limit. So how to find the value for lower and upper limit? So buat macam biasa. 6 minus 2.0537 times with 1.2543. So what will be the lower value?
Three point four two four zero.
And then the upper limit
8.5760.
Okay, so 8.5760. Okay, so this should be your lower and upper limit. Okay, your confidence interval. Or if you want to write the this answer in interval. So dia akan jadi this one lah. So this one dia akan jadi mu A minus mu B. Okay, so before this, for one population, dia jadi mu saja. Sebab tu I cakap I lebih prefer you buat in bracket. Okay, since if these questions, you buat 3.4240 less than mu 8.5760. So this will be wrong. Okay, salah lah. Yeah, you should be mu A minus mu B, since the case is case for two population. Okay, the difference between the two population. So dekat tengah ni dia mesti mu A minus mu B. Okay, so itu kalau you nak buat dalam interval macam tu lah. Okay, so this is how to find the value for lower and upper limit for two population mean. Okay, so if the question asks you to interpret, okay, for example the question asks you to interpret, so interpret macam biasa je, macam biasa je. Kita kata we are 96% confident that, so you just salin je lah. Okay, the mean gas mileage for engine A and B is between 3.4240 and 8.5760 mile per gallon. Okay, so macam tu je lah. The mean gas mileage for engine A and B is between 3.4240 and 8.5760 mile per gallon. So this is how if the question asks you to interpret. Okay, so kalau soalan tak minta, tak perlu pun nak interpret. Okay, so any question? For example 3.9, boleh?
Boleh, miss.
Boleh. Alright, so we look at on the next example. Example for case independent. Still lagi independent, but this case is for variance or standard deviation for the population is unknown for large sample. Okay, so this is the assumption. Okay, so dia adalah random sample and then the population is normally distributed and then both sample size are large. So we have two population, population 1 and population 2. So dua-dua ni sample size dia mesti 30, baru you boleh guna this formula, Z distribution. Okay. So yang berbeza dekat sini, apa beza dia? Beza dia dari segi ni je lah. This one standard deviation, this one variance for the population. Okay, but now dekat sini value dia adalah value variance for sample. Okay, so itu je lah yang berbeza dia. Okay, so kita tengok example 3.10. So kat sini dia kata two kind of thread are being compared for strength. 50 pieces of each type of thread are tested used under similar conditions. So we have brand A and brand B. So brand A had an average tensile strength of 78.3. So we know that both brand ni, dia ada sample size dia is 50. So we have A and B. So kita ada N for A is 50 and for B is also 50. And then for A, dia ada average of 78.3. So 78.3. And then standard deviation is standard deviation for the sample since ayat ni dia dah sekali dah. Okay, so S for A is 5.6. And for B, the average is 87.2. And the standard deviation is 6.3. And the question asks you to construct the 95% confidence interval for the difference of the two of the population means. So dia suruh construct the 95% confidence interval. So alpha over 2 is 0.025. Okay. So macam biasa, first we check either the variance or standard deviation for the population is known. Okay, so since the case is value is for sample, so we know that the variance or standard deviation for the population is unknown. Okay, so when unknown, kita tahu, kita kena check either the sample size is large or small. Okay, so how to check the case? So kita tahu to say that this question is large sample, both population ni mesti n more than and equal to 30. Okay, so memang since kalau kita tengok ni, dua-dua memang lebih or equal to 30. So kita akan guna this formula. Okay, kita akan guna Z distribution. Okay, so nak buat macam mana? Just substitute into the equation. So, S bar A minus S bar B plus minus Z alpha over 2. So yang berbeza dia dekat sini je lah. Dia jadi S. Okay, before this sigma tu je. So just substitute the value 78.3 minus 87.2. Plus minus Z 0.025. Then kita ada 5.6 square over 50. Then plus 6.3 square over 50. Okay. So 78.3 minus 87.2. What will be the value?
Negative 8.9.
Negative 8.9, and then the value for this one, Z 0.0025.
1.9600
here, or 1.96, and then this one, what will be the value? Okay, 1.1921. Okay, and then you dapatkan the lower limit and your upper limit. Okay, so what will be the value for lower limit?
-11.2365.
Okay, so this is your lower limit and your upper limit.
-6.5635.
Okay, so this is your lower and upper limit, or you can write your answer mu A minus mu B. Okay, -6.5635. It's only A, B. Right? So, kalau kita tengok previous example, okay, the question already told you to find the confidence interval for mu A minus mu B. So, kita kena follow lah. Okay. But in this case, since the questions do not mention about either A minus B or B minus A, so you can do mu B minus mu A. Boleh. Okay. So, nanti kat sini dia akan berubah. So, nanti kat sini dia akan jadi 82.7 minus 78.3. So this one nanti you akan dapat 8.9, and your confidence interval dia akan jadi 6.5635, and your upper limit will be 11.2365. And then, or you can write as 6.5635 mu B minus mu A. Okay, so this answer is not wrong. Okay, ni betul. Boleh. Boleh diterima for both answer. Okay, sama je. So, cuma you kena bagi tahulah either you buat B minus A or A minus B. Okay? So, itu adalah untuk example 3.10. Since the question do not ask you to interpret, so no need to interpret. Okay? But if the question ask you to interpret, so macam biasa, we are 95% confident that the difference of the population mean is between this value and this value. Okay? So, any questions regarding example 3.10 boleh? So you kena, so you kena, yang penting you kena check your value for standard deviation tu, either for sample or for population. Okay, supaya you tak salah guna formula. Okay, so this is for example 3.10. So now kita nak tengok on case independent, for the last case for independent, which is the case for our n is less than 30. Okay, so we know that for this case, kita ada dua. Either the variance or standard deviation for both population is equal or unequal variance. Okay, so how? Okay, so how to know either the case is equal or unequal variance? So ni, okay, how to determine the assumption of equality of variances? If the question asks you to find the assumption of equality of variances, so we will use Levin test. Okay, so this is the test that we will use to determine either the equal or unequal variances. So how to do this test? So there are four steps, okay, to do the Levin test. So this is the first step. We let our null and alternative hypothesis. So basically, this step, kita akan tengok on topic 4 actually. Okay, but in this case you kena tahu jugalah. Okay, dekat dalam topic 3 ni. Okay, untuk nak tentukan either the case is equal or unequal variance. Okay, so for first step, we let our null and alternative hypothesis. So this will be your hash null. So hash null is always equal. So kita kata variance pertama is equal to the variance, the second variance. Okay, or our hash 1 is variance pertama unequal to variance yang kedua. So this one you tak boleh terbalik. Hash null must always be equal. Okay, and then hash one must always be unequal. Okay, you tak boleh terbalik kalau you buat hash null unequal macam ni and then hash one equal, so wrong lah your hypothesis. Okay, dia mesti hash null equal, hash one is unequal. Or you can write your hypothesis in sentence lah, in word boleh. So pilih either one je lah, tak perlu buat dua-dua. Okay, so kalau tu you buat simbol je lah, lebih mudah. Okay, so this is the first step. Okay, your hypothesis, you write your hypothesis. The second step is you need to find or you need to write your p-value. Okay, so how to find the value for p-value? So this is your SPSS output. Okay, so kita akan baca on living test for equality of variances. Okay, so yang ni output ni dia ada dari segi horizontal dengan vertical. So yang ni I tunjuk yang ni dulu. Okay, contoh yang ni dulu. Okay, so in this case, dia bagi living test for equality of variances. So kita akan tengok on significant. So this is your p-value. Okay, so this should be the value, 0.298. Okay, so nak baca dia, baca yang dekat sini je, living test ni sahaja. Okay, living test for equality of variances. And then nak dapatkan the value for p-value, kita tengok dekat significant ni. Or the output boleh jadi macam ni juga. Okay, living test for the equality of variances. So kita akan tengok this column only. Okay, so this one tadi kita only tengok this row. So now yang ni kita only look at this column. Okay, so sama, we look at on the significant, this is your p-value. So this should be your p-value. Okay, so nak baca the value for p-value, so you akan tengok dekat living test for equality of variances and you look at the significant. Okay, so this is your p-value. Okay, and then you dah dapatkan the value for p-value and then our decision rule. Okay, so decision rule, we will reject hash null if p-value is less than or equal to alpha. Okay, so yang ni you kena ingat. Okay, so yang decision rule ni memang tak akan berubah sampai you mati. Memang inilah dia punya decision rule dia. Okay, so you kena ingat decision rule untuk p-value, reject hash null if p-value is less than or equal to alpha. Okay, and then buat the decision, macam mana kita nak buat decision dia, either kita nak reject or fail to reject our hash null. So we will compare, okay, our p-value with alpha. Kita akan compare these two value. Okay, so kalau p-value, kita akan compare p-value dengan nilai alpha kita. Okay, so if the value of p-value is less than alpha, so we will reject hash null. Why? Since decision rule kata kita akan reject hash null if p-value is less than or equal to alpha. So maksudnya, if our p-value is 0.5 and our alpha is 0.1, so kita tengok nilai p-value kita ni.
Sekejap. Kau tak tidur pagi semalam.
P-value lebih kecil. So sini contohnya 0.7. Okay, so bila nilai p-value kita 0.5 lebih kecil daripada 0.7, so kita akan kata kita reject hash null. Okay, or contohnya our p-value, value dia adalah 0.5. This is our p-value. And then our alpha pun 0.5. Okay, so since kita kata p-value ni equal to our alpha, so kita akan reject hash null. Okay, or another case, our p-value is 0.5 and then our alpha is 0.1. So since nilai p-value tu lebih besar daripada nilai alpha, so kita fail to reject hash null. Why kita fail to reject hash null? Since kita kata kita akan reject kalau nilai p-value tu less than alpha, less than or equal to alpha saja. Okay, so that is how to reject or fail to reject your hash null. Okay, and then barulah kita buat conclusion. So kita tengoklah kalau kita kata reject, so maksudnya bila reject kita tak nak kita punya hash null ni, kita mengatakan dia unequal. Kalau kita fail to reject, so kita mengatakan dia equal lah. Okay, so nanti akan tengok on the example untuk you lebih faham. Okay, so ingat how to determine the assumption of equality of variances if the question do not mention either the case is equal or unequal variance. So kita kena test dulu. Okay, test our equality of variances. So how to test the equality of variances? We will use living test. Okay, so this is the steps to solve or to test the assumption of equality of variances. Okay, so we look at on the first example for variance or standard deviation for the population is unknown for equal variance. So kita dah tahulah ini adalah case for equal variance. So dekat sini dia kata one or both sample size are less than 30. So salah satu ataupun dua-dua memang less than 30. And then the population is normally distributed. So variance, first variance and second variance for the population are unknown. But the variances are assumed to be equal. So kita kata dia equal variance lah untuk kedua-dua. So kita akan guna this formula, formula yang ada, this value. Okay, iaitu pooled estimate of the standard deviation. So before we substitute the value into the formula, we need to calculate first the value for degree of freedom and your SP, okay, pooled estimate of standard deviation. So macam nak kira, so this is the formula. And then you dah dapat the value and then baru you substitute dekat dalam formula. Okay, so kita tengok example 3.11. So dekat sini dia kata an insurance company wants to know if the average speed at which men drive car is greater than woman driver. Okay, so kita ada dua lah. Kita ada man and woman. Okay. And then the company took a random sample of 26 car driven by men on a highway and found the mean speed to be 72 mile per hour. Okay, so maksudnya we have a sample for man is 26 and the mean is 72 with a standard deviation of 2.2. Okay, so this is all the information about man driver. And then dia kata another sample of 16 car driven by woman. So this is for woman. Okay, 16 cars. And then the average is 68 and the standard deviation is 2.5. Okay. So assume that the speed at which all men and a woman drive car on this highway are both normally distributed with the same population standard deviation. So the question already mentioned about the case which is equal variance. Okay, or equal standard deviation. Okay. So tak ada masalah lah. We know that the case is this one. Okay, equal standard deviation. So construct 98% confidence interval for the difference between the mean speed of car driven by all men and all women. So kita nak cari value for this one. Okay, so how to know which formula we will use? First, we check either the sample, the standard deviation of variance is given for population or sample. So in this case, since the value is for sample, so we know that the variance or standard deviation for the population is unknown. Okay, so bila unknown, kita kena check sama ada dia adalah more than or equal to 30 or less than 30. So since we know that for both sample size ni, dua-dua memang less than 30. Okay, so bila less than 30, so kita akan guna this formula. Kita tahu kita akan guna this formula, but kita kena tengok sama ada dia equal ataupun unequal variance. So macam mana nak tahu, since dekat sini dah mention same population standard deviation. So kita tahu kita akan guna this formula lah. Okay, formula yang ada SP tu. So kita tahu we need to calculate first the value for degree of freedom and SP. So you kira lah dulu. Degree of freedom is n. So 26 plus 16 minus 2. So what will be the value for degree of freedom?
Forty.
Okay, so this is your degree of freedom, and then you need to calculate the value for SP. So just substitute the value into the formula. So and then minus 1 is squared plus. So just substitute the value. So 26 minus 1 and then 2.2 square plus 16 minus 1, 2.5 square over. So this value dah, you dah cari dah. So over 40. So you calculate the value for your SP, yeah, you punya apa nama tu, estimate of standard deviation. So make sure your SP in four decimal places. Okay. So you find the value for SP.
Asal aku sebut 3 minit tu. Rasa lama. Medium tak cakap kan?
2.317.
Okay, you akan dapat 2.3171. Okay. So, this will be your value for SP. And then after calculate the value for degree of the SP, so what to do next is just substitute the value into the formula. Okay. So kita nak cari same in this case. Okay, so kalau you nak buat man minus woman, so boleh, ataupun woman minus man pun boleh ni mana. Okay. So x bar man minus woman plus minus z alpha over 3 alpha over 2 t alpha over 2, and then degree of freedom, and then sp 1 over n man plus 1 over n woman. So just substitute the value. So this 72 minus 68 plus minus t 0.01. So degree of freedom kita dah kira dah, this one 40. So just masukkan kat sini 40. And then SP dah kira dah. So just substitute je. 3171 1 over 26 plus 1 over 16. Okay. So 72 minus 68.
4.
Yes, so this should be 4. And then four. This will be T0.0140. What will be the value?
Two point four two three.
Okay, so this is the value for this one. And then this one.
Berapa lama kau main? Push rank.
Ya ke? Bukan. I suruh you kira ni.
0.7.
Aduh. Kan dah ada. Aduh. Apa? Kau dah nak tulis lah. 2.2.
Alright. So 0.7362. And then you dapatkanlah you punya lower and upper limit. Okay. So what will be your lower limit?
Apa aku tanya kau apa?
2.2162.
Okay, 2.2162, and your upper limit?
5.7838.
Okay, so this is your final answer. Okay. So in this case, the question only asks you to construct the 98% confidence interval. So this will be your final answer. Okay? But if the question asks you to interpret or explain the confidence interval, so macam biasa, we are 98% confidence that the apa nama itu, the difference between the mean speed of car driven by all men and all women on this highway is between 2.2162 and 5.7838. miles per hour. Okay, so if the question ask you to explain or interpret, so apa? Interpret je macam tu. Okay, but if the question do not ask you to interpret, so no need to interpret. Okay, so any questions? For example, 3.11, boleh?
Boleh.
Okay, so kalau boleh kita tengok on the example for. Masih lagi ikut variance, but this case we have SPSS output. Okay, so this is the SPSS output for two population mean for case unequal, sorry, for the case variance or standard ratio for the population is unknown for T distribution. Okay, so in this case, kita ada group statistic. So we know that this is the value for the sample. So this is the value for N1. Okay. So this is for N2. The mean is for mean brand 1 and mean brand 2. Okay, and then the standard deviation for S1 and S2. And then standard error mean is for this one. Okay. So yang dekat group statistik ni dia bagi the descriptive statistic for both population for brand 1 and brand 2. And then kita ada independent sample test. So in this case we already know this is the case for independent sample. Okay, for two population untuk independent. So kita ada dekat sini kita ada Levin test for equality of variance. Okay, so we have this column. And then kita ada, kalau you tengok on this output, kita ada equal variance assume. So this one is for,
saya boleh ajak dia main.
This one. And for the row below is for variance not assumed. So dia berbeza lah. That's why kita kena test dulu sama ada equal ke unequal. Okay, since kalau kita test guna living test ni, kita dapat the case is equal variance. So kita dah tak tengok lah yang bawah ni. Kita hanya tengok the lower and upper limit for this one. Kita hanya tengok the degree of freedom for this one. Okay, but if we test the living test, okay, kita dapat the case is unequal variance. So kita dah tak tengok lah yang atas ni. Okay, kita hanya tengok satu case sahaja. Sama ada case yang pertama ataupun case yang kedua. That's why kita kena test dulu. Kita kena tahu dulu case tu yang mana satu. Equal ke unequal variance. Okay. So
dia akan bagi tahu.
So inilah cara nak baca dia. So in this case 40 ni. So ini kita akan tengok dekat topic 4 nanti. The test statistic. So for degree of freedom. So how to find this value. So for equal variance. So we know that the formula is N1 plus N2 minus 2. So 5 plus 5 minus 2, you will get 8. Okay, 8. Okay, 8. And then for unequal variance, so for unequal variance, the formula will be this one.
Last time.
So this is the formula. So nanti you substitute nilai, you punya S1, N1, semua ni nanti you check, you akan dapat this value. Okay. And then for significant two-tail, so this is for p-value. So p-value ni kita akan tengok in topic 4. Okay, so for mean difference, so mean difference kat sini adalah you punya x bar 1 minus x bar 2. So if the question ask you to find or to show the mean difference, so kita tahulah kita akan tolak this value with this value. Okay, and then mean difference. So tu yang tadi mean difference, and then standard error difference. So standard error difference ni kita tahu standard error difference untuk equal variance adalah yang ini. Yang. Okay, so this one lah. And then kalau untuk equal untuk unequal variance, so this one. So this is the standard error difference. So how to find the value for this one? Okay, nak dapatkan value yang dekat sini. So nanti dia akan ada SP darab dengan 1 over N1 plus 1 over N2. So nak dapatkan value yang ini, dia punya value formula dia lah S1 square over N1 plus S2 square over N2. Okay, so nanti you akan dapat. So if the question ask you to find the standard error difference for the case, so you kena tengoklah case tu equal ke unequal. Kalau case tu equal, so kita akan guna this formula lah. Kalau unequal, kita akan guna this formula. Okay, and then this is the lower and upper limit untuk case equal or unequal. So in this case, we only look at on one case only. Okay, so that's why you kena test sama ada this one or this one. Okay, so tak apa, kita look at on the example. So untuk example 3.12, so kalau you tengok dekat soalan ni, okay, dia kata the manufacturer of a small battery power tech recorder decide to include 4 alkaline battery with its product. So the two battery supplier are being considered, each has its own brand 1 and brand 2. So dia kata the supervising inspector of incoming quality wants to know if the average lifetime of the two brand are the same. So a sample experiment is conducted. So kita ada 5 for brand 1, 5 for brand 2, and then this is the result. So kalau you tengok in this paragraph, dia tak ada mention pun pasal equal or unequal variance. Okay, so that's why kalau you tengok dekat sini, for question A, based on the p-value in living test, test the equality of variances in this study. Okay, they suruh you test the equality of variances. So, how to do these questions? Kita akan refer balik for the four step. Okay, to solve the assumption of equality of variances. Okay, first step is your hypothesis. So, to answer this question, so for question A, how to answer the questions? So, first step is your hypothesis. Your H null and your H1. Okay, so your H null is macam I kata, H null is always equal. And then for H1, dia akan jadi unequal. So kita nak check sama ada case dia yang ini ataupun yang ini. Okay? And then next step is our p-value. So how to find p-value for living test? So, macam saya kata, we will look at the living test for equality of variances. So, kita akan tengok dekat column this one. And kita akan tengok dekat significant. This is your p-value for living test. So, this will be the value 0.459. Okay, so itu adalah you punya p-value. And then your alpha is, since the question asks you to use 0.05. And then third step is your decision rule, which is reject H null if p value is less than or equal to alpha. So this is your decision rule. Okay, so after decision rule, we have decision. Okay, so kita ada decision rule and then kita ada decision. So for decision, kita akan compare the value dekat step yang kedua ni. Kita akan compare our p-value dengan our alpha. Okay, so kita kata since p-value is equal to 0.459, so kalau kita tengok this value ni lebih besar ke, lebih kecil ke, ataupun sama dengan
0.05?
Lebih kecil ke lebih besar? Lebih besar. Okay, so since kita kata nilai ni lebih besar daripada alpha, so kita reject ke kita fail to reject?
Mabuk
lah.
Fail to reject H null. Why kita fail to reject H null? Sebab kita tahu decision rule kita, rule dia kalau kita nak reject H null ni, mesti nilai p-value tu less than or equal to alpha. Okay, if the value, p-value tu more than alpha, so kita fail to reject
kalau
lah.
Kalau tak reject, okay. Orang
so, we only use term reject or fail to reject H null. Kita tak ada guna istilah accept H1, tak ada eh. Okay, kita hanya ada sama ada reject or fail to reject H null. Or kalau you confuse, kita kata since p-value more than alpha, kita fail to reject. So, you tengok dekat sini lah nilai p-value ni, you compare. Okay, apa-apa you refer kepada you punya decision rule ni. Okay, so in this case, since kita kata kita fail to reject H null, so conclusion kita akan jadi apa? So kita kata fail to reject H null, so maksudnya kita mengatakan dia equal ke unequal?
Dia equal.
Equal. Okay, so this will be our conclusion, equal variance. Okay, so kalau kat sini kita reject H null, so kita reject H null, kita tak nak dia, so kita mengatakan dia unequal lah. Okay, so bila kita dah confirm, kita dah test and kita dapat equal variance. So we know that the case is equal variance. So this one you ignore sahaja. Since we know that this will be our case, equal variance. Okay, so itu for A, dia suruh test sahaja. So now kita dah tahu. For B, dia kata state. So bila state, you only look at your output. Okay, your confidence interval at your output. Since dekat sini dia kata state 95% confidence interval, so now memang kita guna 95% confidence interval. So since kita memang dah test, kita dapat equal variance, so this one you ignore je lah. And then bila state, saya kata just tulis sahaja. So 5.682, 19.518. Dia suruh state, so you just state sahaja, tak perlu nak kira. Okay, since markah dia selalu satu markah je. Okay, so that's why penting dekat A ni, for example dekat A ni, you dapat your answer, you dapat unequal variance. So nanti dekat B, you akan tengok value yang dekat bawah ni. Okay, you akan tengok yang this one. So nanti you akan jawab 5.617, 19.583. So this will be wrong. Okay, so you punya jawapan akan salah lah. That's why you kena tengok betul-betul. Since kalau A ni betul, B akan betul. Tapi kalau A ni you dah salah, so B ni pun akan salah lah. Okay, so you kena tengok betul-betul. Ataupun B ni dah betul dah, you dapat equal. Tiba-tiba you pergi tengok dekat unequal. So salah jugalah you punya apa nama itu, confidence interval. Okay, so itu adalah untuk B. So bila dia kata state, so you just state the value. Okay, kalau dia kata find or calculate, barulah you guna formula yang ada SP. So nilai dia semua dah ada lah. Okay, you tak perlu nak kira nilai SP since ini dah memang untuk you punya standard error difference. So just substitute je lah. Okay, if the question ask you to calculate, for example calculate, so kita bila calculate tu nanti x bawah minus x bar 2 plus minus t alpha over 2 n minus 1 SP 1 over n1 plus 1 over n2. For example, if the question ask you to calculate. So value ni semua dah ada dah ni. Okay, since kita nak tengok equal je, so this is the mean difference, just masukkan je lah. 12.6 plus minus t 0.025 n minus 1, so degree of freedom dah ada dah, 8. So you tak, sorry, ni bukan n minus 1, ni degree of freedom. n1 plus n2 minus 2. So dah ada dah ni ha, 8. And then this one pun you dah ada dah, this is the value. Okay, just substitute je lah. Okay, so itu kalau question suruh you calculate or show or prove. So you just ambil je daripada daripada output. Okay, so nanti baru you buat the answer lah. So kalau the question ask you to state, tapi you show all the calculation, so saya memang takkan terima lah jawapan you. Okay, sebab question ask you to state, dia bukan suruh you show or calculate. So just bagi this value only, tak perlu nak masukkan dalam formula. Okay, since markah dia hanya satu sahaja. So make sure you faham betul-betul lah soalan tu dia nak apa. Okay. So itu adalah untuk question B. Okay. And the last one, for C, based on the confidence interval, okay, can we conclude that the average lifetime of the two brain are equal? Okay. So kita tahu kalau based on the confidence interval, kita akan refer kepada nilai zero. Since dekat situ dia tak ada mention nilai dia berapa. So kita tengok kosong tu ada ke tak ada dalam confidence interval. Okay, so this one lah kita akan refer kepada this one. So sama juga dalam case yang ini. Okay, so for C, kita boleh kata average lifetime of the two brain equal ke tak? Boleh kata equal ke tak boleh kata equal? Boleh. So kalau kita tengok, kalau kita tengok kosong tu dia duduk kat mana? Kosong ni dia duduk dekat dekat luar. So kalau dia duduk dekat dalam luar confidence interval, so kita kata dia equal ke kita kata dia unequal ataupun ada differ?
Ada differ.
Ada differ. So boleh ke kita kata dia equal?
Tak.
Tak boleh. So no.
Pandai.
We cannot conclude that the average lifetime of the two brain are equal. And then don't forget the reason, since zero is not in the confidence interval. Macam tu je lah. Okay. So itu adalah untuk questions 3.12 4C. Okay, so any questions regarding example 3.12 ni boleh?
Tanya.
Boleh tak?
Tanya.
Okay, so kalau tak je tak ada problem, kita tengok on the last one. Okay, for case variance or standard deviation for the population is unknown, for case small sample and the case is unequal variance. So untuk unequal variance kita akan guna this formula. Okay, yang mana formula ni tak ada SP. Okay, tak ada, tak ada value SP dekat sini. But we need to calculate the value for degree of freedom. Okay, you just substitute into the formula. Okay, formula dalam ni. So, kita tengok example 3.13. Okay, so kat sini dia kata the breaking string of 11 bundle of wool fiber have a sample mean of 436.5 and a sample standard deviation of 11.9. So kita ada dua, kita ada wool fiber and another 12 bundle of synthetic fiber. So kita ada dua lah. Kita ada wool and synthetic.
Okay.
So you, macam biasa, you just list all the information okay, regarding the population. And then this one, standard deviation. So for synthetic, kita ada 12 and then kita ada 452.8 and sample standard deviation is 3.61. And then assume the breaking string of data population are normally distributed with unequal variance. So you tahulah this case is unequal variance. Okay, so macam biasa dia suruh construct 95% confidence interval. So our alpha will be 0.05. So alpha over 2 is 0.025. Okay. So buat macam biasa, kita check this is case for variance or deviation for the population is unknown. So bila unknown, kita kena check sama ada both sample tu large or salah satu large ataupun dua-dua kecil. So in this case, dua-dua ni memang kecil. So kita tahu kita akan guna T distribution. But for T distribution, kita ada dua condition sama ada equal ataupun unequal variance. So kita kena check. So dalam case ni memang dia dah mention dah unequal variance. So kita tahu kita akan guna this formula. Okay, so before we substitute into the formula, kita kena calculate dulu the degree of freedom. So kiralah dulu degree of freedom, substitute lah dekat dalam formula. So formula dia macam panjang sikit. Okay, so you just substitute je lah the value. Wool over and wool. Okay. So just substitute the value. Okay, value yang ini semua ni, you just masukkan sahaja dekat dalam formula. Over 11 plus 3.61 square over 12 square over 11.9 square over 11 square over this one plus 3.61 square over 12 square over 12 minus 1. So in this case, kalau you tak yakin, okay, kalau you tak yakin nak kira semua sekali, you kira je satu-satu. You kira dulu this value and then you dapatkan this value. And then you dapatkan this value. Okay. So what is the value for degree of freedom? So you kira nilai degree of freedom ni.
Jadi biaya impact apa tu? Throw impact yang besar. Tinggi sangat. Kau kena tulis kat yang tu dia jadi contoh kena tulis kat tempat-tempat yang besar tu baru jadi okey kalau jauh. Beri aku nak try pasang lagu tu agak kucing kan dunia beri ya aku ham aku.
So ada yang dah dapat value untuk degree of freedom?
11.68 tu.
Okay, 11.6827. Okay, so we know that dekat dalam statistical table, okay, so kita tak ada point yang macam tu. Okay, kita tak ada 11.6827 tu. So, what we need to do is, kita kena round off the value. Okay, so how to round off the value? So, kita akan round off to the lowest. Okay, so maksudnya in this case, between 11 dengan 12, kita akan round off dia kepada 11. Okay, so kita akan round off dia kepada 11. For example, you dapat 11.999. For sama, you akan round off kepada 11, bukan 12. Okay, melainkan you dapat 12.1, ha, yang ni baru you round off kepada 12. Maksudnya, you just ambil nilai yang kat depan ni saja. Okay, so itu adalah cara macam mana you nak round off your degree of freedom. Okay, so nanti bila you... So kita tahu this case is unequal. So nanti bila you masukkan dekat dalam formula tu,
salah kira
plus minus t alpha over 2 degree of freedom, then this one as square over n. Okay, so just substitute the value 436.5 minus 452.8. And then this one nanti dia akan jadi T 0.025. So degree of freedom ni you akan masukkan 11 sahaja. Ni 11 sahaja. And then this one 11.9 square over 11 plus 3.61 square over 12. Okay. So nanti this one you solve the problems and then you check dapat tak this answer. Okay, and then the last example ni nanti you cuba juga. Okay, example 3.14. So this one sama. You test the living test and then you state the 95% confidence interval, and then based on the confidence interval boleh ke kita conclude. So tengok 0 tu ada ke tak dalam confidence interval.
Dah habis,
and then dia suruh show the degree of freedom. So you guna formula this one lah. Okay. So nanti you try the answer. So kita akan discuss on next week lah, since kelas esok kita cuti. So esok cuti, so kita akan jumpa next week. So next week kita akan discuss on this example first, before kita tengok on last for dependent. Okay, lepas tu kita habislah chapter 2. Okay, so any questions before we end our class? Ada apa-apa nak tanya?
Tak ada ni.
Tak ada. Okay, so kalau tak ada, okay, so kalau tak ada, thank you for today. Jangan lupa isi attendance. So see you next week. Thank you.
See you next week. Take care, Miss. Jaga diri. Selamat berbuka.
Thank you, Miss. Selamat berbuka, Miss.
Selamat berbuka.
Thank you.
Eh, lambat lagi.
Apa? Awal-awal.
Miss, nak tengok yang example last kali tadi? Nak screenshot je.
Screenshot apa?
Yang... example last kali tadi, 3.13 tadi.
Oh.
Boleh nak.
Sekejap
eh.
Ada tak? Boleh tak?
Okay,
sekejap.
Order dia.
Sekejap. So nanti you try dapat the answer.
Dia ada feeling kakak-kakak.
Okay, dah dapat, Miss. Thank you.
Alright.
Ya. Yeah. Nah, aku tengok muka dia.
Okay, thank you, Miss.
Okay.
Allah dia